do one of the literature relations class 10, PATOL BABU or FILMSTAR by Satyajit. Let me give you introduction of the lesson and then after we'll go for line by line explanation. The fact that PATOL BABU or FILMSTAR is a beautiful story that narrates how an actor reaches his perfection in acting through his practice and rehearsal. PATOL BABU, being a theatre actor, reaches the perfection of being a very good actor in a film, though was given a very small role, a very tribal role. The role that was given to PATOL BABU was insignificant. It was a monologue just to say, oh, the one word dialogue. Yet he brought perfection in his acting, and by virtue of bringing perfection in his acting, he proved himself as an actor of excellence. Actor of excellence. The fact that the story also highlights the struggle of a common man to earn his livelihood. PATOL BABU started his career as a theatre actor. People bought tickets to see the drama or the skit played in which PATOL BABU was having a leading role. People personally wanted to see PATOL BABU, and for that reason they purchased the ticket. On the handbills of the shopkeepers, the name of PATOL BABU was printed. This clearly suggests that he was a popular actor so far as the theatre acting was concerned. He had his mentor and guru, Gogon Pakrasi, who used to say that no role is small or insignificant. What did he say? Just tell. No role is insignificant. No role is unimportant. What matters is how an actor brings best out of what is being given to him. Say like that. According to his mentor, PATOL BABU's mentor, it is more important to bring best out of one's role. That is more important. No role is insignificant. Say like that. No role is insignificant.
No role is insignificant.
What matters is how an actor brings the best out of whatever is being given to him. And an actor's role is to and acting is just like a fruit. And an actor's role is to extract juice from the fruit and serve it to the audience. The best way he serves to the audience, the best actor he is.
So,
acting by profession is something that requires a lot of, practice, a lot of experience. PATOL BABU had his history of being a struggler throughout his life. He worked as a clerk in a, railway factory. And then he worked in Hudson and Kimberley for 9 years as a senior clerk. He was being paid very well. And that time, he shifted himself to a flat also. Everything was easy going for him. He earned a considerable amount of money while working in Hudson and Kimberley. He progressed a lot, but suddenly the factory was retrenched and the number of employees were reduced due to war. So due to sudden retrenchment, PATOL BABU had to give up his job. And after he lost his job, he had a struggle, continuous struggle. Then he worked for 10 years as an insurance agent. And then another, 4 or 5 years, he started a stationery shop. And that also couldn't work. He was a big failure in that. He couldn't run the shop and he had a big loss. Thereafter that, he also worked as a scrap dealer along with some other person. And then recently, he was without any work. He was struggling and in search of job. Meanwhile, one of his neighbor, contacted him and asked him to play a role. Actually, Narista, a film producer, was in search of a middle-aged man like PATOL BABU, short height, bald-headed, and he was looking for such a person to play the role of a pedestrian. To play the role of what? Tell me.
A pedestrian.
Narista told Nishikanto Ghosh, a neighbor of PATOL BABU, that PATOL BABU will suit that role because he is your neighbor. So please ask him to stay tomorrow and at 10 o'clock, Naresh Dutt, his brother-in-law, will come and talk to him about the role. Patrol Babu was desperately waiting for Naresh Dutt next morning. He had to go for shopping also. He was so excited to hear this offer that he mixed up the list of shopping. In place of red chili, he purchased ginger, and in place of ginger, he purchased red chili. So he made a complete confusion because of excitement. And that, you know, after that, he just became little restless when Patrol Babu didn't turn up. It was just 12 o'clock when Patrol Babu knocked at the door. And, you know, Naresh Dutt looked at the Patrol Babu's door. And then Patrol Babu took him in by hand in his house and made him sit in a chair. And he said that, well, I just think you will not turn up my offer. I'm searching for a middle-aged man like you who is bald-headed and 50 years of age. And I'm looking for a small role in a film. So would you mind playing that role? Patrol Babu said, I would never mind. Rather, I would gladly accept this role. The role was of an absent-minded pedestrian. The role was of an absent-minded pedestrian. And then, you know, Naresh told Patrol Babu to reach Sunday morning at 8:30 sharp at, you know, Faraday Street in Kolkata, where the shooting will take place. And then Patrol Babu, next morning, Sunday, he reached there by 8:20 sharp and was waiting for, Naresh Dutt. There were a large crowd of people over there, and they were all like cameramen, light men, and many others, assistants who could help in shooting a film. But he could know nobody else other than Naresh Dutt. And therefore, he was looking desperately for Naresh Dutt's arrival. He asked some of the passers-by where he could meet Naresh Dutt. And then he also wanted to know about Chanchal Kumar, who was the leading actor in that very film. So everybody just told that he should have patience, but he was desperately, waiting for his dialogue. And he asked one of these, young chap standing there, that what would be his role, whether it will be a writing part or a speaking part or just a role without dialogue. But then everything was just clear. When Naresh Dutt came, he asked one of the boys to write his role. And he wrote in a piece of paper, oh, single word, a monologue. Patrol Babu felt little cheated. He just felt that he was deceived by Naresh Dutt, because he has promised him that his role would be a speaking part. But when he actually got the dialogue, it was just single word, oh, written on a small piece of paper. And that really made Patrol Babu feel cheated. He just thought that he was wasting his time waiting for all this. But later on, he was reminded of his mentor's word, Gogon Pakrasi's words. His mentor used to say, no role is insignificant. What matters is how you bring best out of your, role, and how you, serve the audience, how you attract the audience through your, better acting. So the words of his mentor, Gogon Pakrasi, really made him, a little bit inspired. And he started rehearsing his role, by mixing feelings of pain, surprise, excitement, and a little bit of annoyance. So he mixed up 25% of pain, 25% of, surprise, 25% of annoyance. And like that, he made such a big rehearsal in front of a mirror just nearby, that he really just thought that every time when he was rehearsing, there was a different meaning coming out of oh. And therefore, he made a perfect rehearsal of what he was going to do. The shooting is started. Chanchal Kumar came out of the car, and he was to dash him, he was to collide him. Patrol Babu collided with Chanchal Kumar and just said oh with such a perfection that everybody remained astounded. His action was so perfect, his words and his mixing of feelings were so perfect that everybody just appreciated Patrol Babu and just proved that he was really a good actor. So that is how Patrol Babu, by performing his role in the best way, made it prove that he was really a good actor. And he left the place without taking his payment. That was really surprising to Varun Malik, his director. When he asked everybody, where is Patrol Babu, they said he had left the place. So for Patrol Babu, it was not important to get the wages or the salary. What was more important, that he had done his work with such a great satisfaction that he just thought that his satisfaction and achievement was more important than what the wages you would get out of that role or out of that acting. That is the reason why PATOL Babu left the place without bothering about the payment. So this, I mean, story proves that a real actor is one who does perfection in his acting by virtue of his better performance without caring about what wages he was going to get. PATOL Babu was such a renowned, such an excellent actor, and really for that reason he was praised by all of them. Even his director Baran Malik praised him for his excellent performance. Though it was a single word, I mean dialogue, yet he proved contributing to the role of the film, and he proved himself to be the superior of all of the actors there. And that is how we come to conclude the, I mean, story PATOL Babu. Thank you.